Now we are going to answer a fundamental question, and that question is how exactly a protein is directed towards nucleus. So if you look at the proteins that are directed towards nucleus, there is a set of sequences in the protein that is known as NLS. NLS stands for nuclear localization sequences. Nuclear localization sequences. Now onwards we will use NLS. This is a set of sequences that has a many lysine and arginine residue. A common style is there will be these are amino acid residues, one amino acid, then you will find an arginine very specific, then there is a lysine very specific, then there may be about 12 non-significant residues of amino acid. Then you will find about 3 either arginine or lysine residues. And then is the protein of interest that has to be transported into the nucleus. So this forms a kind of an NLS. So this is an NLS that is directing a particular protein into the nucleus. Now the question is, how are proteins imported to the nucleus? A lot of studies were carried out in order to understand this mechanism. One such study is worth looking at, a very simple study, a lot of technical skill is needed. What was done is, they took a protein which is not a nuclear protein, and that, let us say, it is BSA, bovine serum albumin. It is not a nuclear protein. So this nuclear protein, what was done is, in an oocyte, it's a large egg, in an oocyte, so it has the nucleus, this BSA was injected, okay, BSA is injected. So when BSA is injected, let us assume that this is the nanogram injected per cell, okay, nanogram injected per cell. So let us assume this is our x-axis. So here is, we are starting from 0, 200, let's say 400, 600, 800, etc. Okay, nanograms of a BSA injected per cell. And on the y-axis, we will take the nuclear accumulation. Okay, so this is the y-axis, this is the nuclear accumulation. Accumulation that is moles per minute per cells. Okay, moles per minute per cell. So let us put values like 2, 4, 6, etc., and 8, etc. Okay, just for understanding how the experiment was carried out. What did they observe? They injected BSA here. So BSA is here. Now, as the concentration increase, they observe, so another cell here, this is the nucleus. What was observed is the BSA got spread. BSA is stayed in the cytoplasm itself over a period of time. It stayed in the cytoplasm. So this is just BSA only. Now, what they did, along with this BSA, this is the BSA, along with the BSA, a sequence, an NLS is added. So NLS is added to the BSA. Now what should happen with the NLS? That should direct the BSA towards the nucleus. That is the hypothesis. So here is the cell, again the nucleus, and this is injected here, and okay, injected, and what happened is, and the graph is something like this, which means over a period of time, the entire nucleus got filled with the NLS BSA, and there was nothing in the cytoplasm. So this is the kind of experiment to show that there is a sequence that is required for directing a protein to a particular location, especially in this case into nucleus. A very, very fundamental study, but requiring a lot of skill in order to monitor this. When we look at NLRS receptors, so NLRS receptors, these are soluble proteins. These are soluble cytoplasmic proteins. Okay. Now, these soluble cytoplasmic proteins, we have seen that there are very specific these kind of receptors for each cargo. So each cargo is recognized by a very specific receptor. Now it is like, you know, it is like the fast tag. So when you know that if there is a fast tag attached to your vehicle is allowed to pass through. Now these receptor should have two properties. One property is it should be able to bind to the cargo. It should be able to bind to the cargo. And the second post, the property is it should be able to bind to the location where especially the FG nucleopolis. So it should bind to the receptor as well as it should be able to bind to the FG nucleus. Then only the cargo can be transported into the nucleus. There are two kinds of such NLRS receptors identified. The first kind of NLRS receptor is it will directly bind to the cargo and it is transported. A simple diagrammatic representation, if you consider this is the cargo to be transported, so this is our cargo and this is the NLRS receptor. So, this is the sequences, NLRS sequences. What happens is it has a kind of a protein and let us call this one is the beta protein. It binds, it identifies, and these are called the importing proteins. That is called the importings. Importings, and they are also known as karyophorins. Okay, now in the these are a monomeric units and this binds and then this is transported. So this is transported, assume that this is our nucleopore and it is transported inside. One simple way to transport it, so as we have seen this important protein, they should be able to bind to the cargo as well as they should be able to bind to the FC nucleoporin which is present here, then it is simply transported inside. That's one possibility. If the second possibility is the second kind of receptor is this a cargo and in order to bind with the important, it needs, it's a heterodimer. It also has, let us say that this has an alpha region. Okay, this is the alpha region. And the alpha region also, it becomes a kind of a docking mechanism. So it has to dock and then the entire unit is brought inside. Once it is brought inside, so the alpha unit gets separated, the beta unit gets separated, and then your cargo also gets separated. The cargo is separated. Another kind of NLRS receptor which is used for transporting proteins inside the nucleus.